Good evening and welcome to Second Presbyterian Church to this Good Friday concert of sacred music. Tonight we continue our journey that began on Ash Wednesday. We followed Jesus each Sunday of Lent and heard him as he taught his disciples. And he showed us how to take up our crosses in order to become God's faithful witnesses. On Palm Sunday, we wave palm branches, remembering the triumphal entry of our Lord into Jerusalem. Last night, we remembered that Jesus shared a Passover meal with his disciples in the upper room, and he washed the disciples' feet before being whisked away in a mock trial. We heard the crowd shout, "Crucify him, crucify him," before he was whipped and scourged and carried the instrument of his death to Golgotha's hill. Tonight we will hear in word and song the story of the last moments of his life as recorded by Matthew, Luke, and John as he offers his life for the sins of the world. We are invited in these difficult to reflect on the depth of human sin tonight, as well as the passion of God, our Redeemer, to save us. Our presentation of the words of Christ by Dubois was instituted by Edward Eigenschenk in 1928 to great artistic acclaim. We continue this tradition tonight, and we are grateful that you are here in this solemn remembrance of Christ's last hours on earth. At the conclusion of the service, we ask you to exit the doors of the sanctuary in silence, remembering the meaning of the death of Jesus of Nazareth. And we invite you to continue with us as the story unfolds to the great astonishment of Easter. On Sunday, we will celebrate the joy of the resurrection with harp music, which will begin at 10:40, followed by festive choral and organ music. Please join us for worship this Sunday morning. In a few moments after our hymn, there will be a free will offering to benefit the music ministry of Second Presbyterian Church. Sunday in, Sunday out, we all agree that we are offered glorious music in this beautiful sanctuary. Your gifts will enable the music of Second Presbyterian Church to continue to minister to the community and offer musical events for our community uplift. And now let us stand and sing our first hymn. Thank you.
And if the ushers will come forward at this time, we will receive an offering given to the glory of God for the music program and ministry of Second Presbyterian Church. Let us pray for God's word and God's spirit to illuminate this service. Almighty God, you love the world so much that your Son was sent not to condemn the world, but that through him the world might be saved. Tonight, as we are confronted again with the depth of human wickedness, the greater depth of your divine compassion, may we not remain unmoved. As we hear the sacred story of our redemption, help us to follow where he walked, to listen as he cries out, to hurt as he suffers, to bow our heads in sorrow as he dies, so that when he is raised to life again, we may share your endless joy. As Christ's arms are stretched out and his body is lifted up, may our souls be grasped by what our minds alone cannot contain, that this was all done for us. And so, Lord, may we be all for you. And all God's people said, amen. Thank you.
While Jesus was going up to Jerusalem, he took the 12 disciples aside by themselves and said to them on the way, "See, we are going up to Jerusalem, and the Son of Man will be handed over to the chief priests and scribes, and they will condemn him to death. Then they will hand him over to the Gentiles to be mocked, flogged, and crucified. And on the third day, he will be raised."
Children of children. One of the criminals who were hanged there kept deriding him and saying, "Are you not the Messiah? Save yourself and us." But the other rebuked him, saying, "Do you not fear God, since you are under the same sentence of condemnation? And we indeed have been condemned justly, for we are getting what we deserve for our deeds. But this man has done nothing wrong." Then he said, "Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom." He replied, "Truly, I tell you, today you will be with me in paradise."
When the soldiers had crucified Jesus, they took his clothes and divided them into four parts, one for each soldier. They also took his tunic. Now the tunic was seamless, woven in one piece from the top. So they said to one another, "Let us not tear it, but cast lots for it to see who will get it." This was to fulfill what the scripture says, "They divided my clothes among themselves, and for my clothing they cast lots." And that is what the soldiers did. Meanwhile, standing near the cross of Jesus was his mother, and his mother's sister Mary, the wife of Clopas, and Mary Magdalene. When Jesus saw his mother and the disciple whom he loved standing beside her, he said to his mother, "Woman, here is your son." Then he said to the disciple, "Here is your mother." And from that hour, the disciple took her into his own home.
Peter said to him, "Though all become deserters because of you, I will never desert you." Jesus said to him, "Truly I tell you, this very night, before the cock crows, you will deny me three times."
Oh, And the people stood by watching. But the leaders scoffed at him, saying, "He saved others, let him save himself, if he is the Messiah of God, his chosen one." The soldiers also mocked him, coming up and offering him sour wine, and saying, "If you are the King of the Jews, save yourself." There was also an inscription over him, "This is the King of the Jews."
justice. If it were not so, would I have told you that I go to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and will take you to myself, so that where I am, there you may be also. And you know the way to the place where I am going."
Thank you.
In you, O Lord, I seek refuge. Do not let me ever be put to shame. In your righteousness, deliver me. Incline your ear to me. Rescue me speedily. Be a rock of refuge for me, a strong fortress to save me. You are indeed my rock and my fortress. For your name's sake, lead me and guide me. Take me out of the net that is hidden for me. For you are my refuge. Into your hand I commit my spirit. You have redeemed me, O Lord, faithful God.
Glory.